Yes, good afternoon, sir. Sir, can you see my screen?
Yes, please go ahead.
Yes, sir. Sir, I'm Dr. Upali Tiwari, and I'm presenting a case of angle closure glaucoma with diabetes, a dual challenge. Sorry, I'm not able to move my slides.
Just put a single click on the slide anywhere and then.
Yeah, you can use a slide sorter to just move forward. Yeah,
it's going now.
Can you full screen, ma'am?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Glaucoma is one of the leading causes of irreversible blindness worldwide. It's the second most common cause of blindness after cataract. 1/3 of total glaucoma populations are from primary angle closure glaucoma. It's a group of disease in which there are reversible or additional closure of the anterior chamber angle. The angle closure may occur in an acute or chronic form. We had a chronic form which may develop after acute angle closure where sinical closure of the angle persists, or it may develop over time as the angle closes from repeated contact between the peripheral iris and trabecular mass shrug, which often leads to peripheral and anterior synecae. We have neovascular glaucoma. It's a sight-threatening secondary glaucoma characterized by appearance of the new vessels over the iris and proliferation of the fibrovascular tissue in the anterior chamber angle. Retinal ischemia is one of the most common driving factor for neovascularization, and the common causes are CRVO and PDR. The current rise in the prevalence of neovascular glaucoma is mainly related to increased diabetes mellitus cases nowadays. I had a patient of 60 years, female. Patient came with a complaint of ocular pain, redness, and diminution of vision in left eye since 15 days. According to the patient, she was apparently all right 6 years back when she developed diminution of vision in both eye. In left eye, the diminution of vision was mildly painful, associated with redness and watering, headache, and she has had multiple episodes of the same complaint. In right eye, diminution of vision was sudden in onset, painful in nature, associated with redness, watering, and floaters. She had multiple episodes of same associated with headache and vomiting also. She has history of right eye trabeculectomy by documents 2 years back and history of left eye cataract surgery and with intravitreal injection 4 months back. She was using eye drops, vimonidine and timolol combination and dorzolamide when she came to the hospital. And she was a known case of diabetes mellitus type 2 and systemic hypertension for which she was taking medications. In the ocular examination in right eye, the vision was with no perception of light. Conjunctival congestion was present with a well-formed bleb suggesting trabeculectomy. Cornea was clear, anterior chamber was shallow with VH grade 1. Iris color was normal, pattern was disturbed, and posterior synecae were present in the eye. Hyperpigmented patch was present in inferior temporal quadrant of the iris. Pupil center and not reacting to light. Cataract was lenses cataract NS grade 2, and the NCT was raised 24.7 mm Hg. And in left eye, vision was PL positive and PR accurate. Conjunctiva was congested, cornea was clear, anterior chamber was shallow, VH grade 1, and in the pupillary margin, vasculation was present in the iris and it was extending up to the periphery. There was also ectropion, uvea was present in the iris. Pupil was also central and not reacting to light. Shining reflex was present, indicating pseudophakia, and distal pressure was raised, but NCT was non-recordable. In the fundus, the patient didn't comply to the fundus picture because she was already in very very much pain when she came. So we took the liberty to draw the fundus. The media in right eye, the media was mild hazy due to lens opacity. There was vitreoretinal traction bands associated with slight vitreous degeneration present. This margin was distinct and clear circular. CDR was 0.9:1, and the blood vessels in the veins were dilated and tortuous. Foveal reflex was not appreciated. In the general fundus, we had vitreoretinal fibrovascular traction bands present in the supratemporal and supranasal quadrant. In the left eye fundus, the media was clear, disc margin was distinct, and neovascularization was present in the temporal margin of the disc. And CDR was 0.8:1. Foveal reflex was not appreciable. In general fundus, there were multiple flame-shaped hemorrhages present in all the four quadrants. And there was a neovascularization tuft present inferior temporally, which suggested CRVO. My provisional diagnosis was right eye proliferative diabetic retinopathy with angle closure glaucoma, glaucomatous optic neuropathy with NS grade 2 cataract. In left eye, CRVO, neovascular glaucoma, and glaucomatous optic neuropathy with pseudophakia. We did the investigation. We couldn't do the
FFA. Dr. Rupali, we need to conclude your talk. Is there any questions for Dr. Rupali based on differential diagnosis?
Dr. Upali, why was the MCT used for measuring the pressure? Any specific reason?
Sir, because the patient was not complying to another form of the other form of management of IOP because she was in pain, so she didn't comply to Shiodes or anything else.
Okay.
Do you do ablation?
Yes, ma'am.
Do you ablation? Actually, if you're presenting in a forum, NCT is not the one that you should be using. Yes, and when you are presenting, a small suggestion, you don't have to go on with the history so much. And what was the basic reason for you to be presenting this case?
My basic reason was presenting this case because I found it very compelling, because she already had angle closure glaucoma beforehand, before the diabetic part. And she got in the right, she already had proliferative diabetic retinopathy. She has no vision. She has already glaucomatous damage all over in the right eye. And she just had done cataract surgery 4 months back. And after the cataract surgery, most probably the neovascularization developed and neovascular glaucoma in the left eye then developed in the eye. That's why I found the case compelling to present, ma'am. I'm sorry, it was not well versed.
Please do a proper workup when you are presenting.
Yes, ma'am. Yes,
and you don't need to go on, and your slides should be also more succinct rather than giving a text and prose. Thank you.